tasting room itself. It was originally built in 1927, I think, and it was a barbershop. So the guy started as a barbershop, then he converted into a barbershop and a pool hall, because that's what everybody should have. And then it became a pool hall and a card hall, so pool up front, cards in back. And then it sort of evolved into a bunch of different things. So it actually became a library. It was known as the old library. So this was actually the township library for a long time. Then it became an antique shop that my aunt and uncle ran out of here for a long time. And then it became a realty office, and now it's a tasting room. So it's pretty much seen a little bit of everything, and it's time on this earth. And everything in this building was original from town, and most of it was salvaged products from other projects. So the bricks on the front are actually from the church in town. I can't remember where the bricks on the side are from. The floor was just original. It was taken from a bunch of different housing sites in town. So it was actually the original floor that was installed. Pretty interesting building, pretty unique tasting room for us. It's right here in town. We started this back in 05. So it was my father, my uncle, myself, who sat down and said, okay, wineries are doing really well here. We've always been big wine drinkers. Collectors. My dad and my uncle both have extensive cellars of wine. And we sort of watched it continue to grow here. And we're starting to just taste some really good wines. And so we said, okay, this area definitely has some great potential. And so in 05, we sort of said, okay, can we make this work? Do we really want to do this? And then in 06, we really sort of figured out financially, you know, what's the long-term business model? How can this all work? How can we fund it? Who wants to run this thing forever? Because my dad is retiring. He's like, I don't want to do this forever. And nor does my uncle. So we're trying to figure out, okay, did I want to take it over? You know, how are we going to do with succession planning and all those types of things? And we sort of settled on, okay, this thing can work. And so back in 06, we purchased a piece of property up on Matheson Road, which is about 8 miles north of here. And then in 2007, we planted 19 acres of vines up on that property. And that same fall, we bought another piece of property just down the road from it. And we planted that over the last few years. So right now we have about 28 acres of vineyards in production. We have another 5 to 7 acres to plant next year. So we're going to plant the last chunk of our land in 2012. And that's all set up north of town here. So that's how we sort of got started in this whole thing, just sort of growing our own grapes and knowing that this is what we kind of wanted to do. And then in terms of winemaking, longtime family friends with Sean Walters, and we knew that Sean was working with Doug Thias and French Road Cellars, and it just seemed like it was the perfect fit. So this is actually our first vintage. So we made about 1,800 cases of wine this year. We spread across some whites, a few reds, some cherry wines as well. So in terms of our wines right now, we have 5 wines plus a hard cider in here right now. We have an unwooded Chardonnay. We will have a reserve Chardonnay shortly, which was done in oak. So our unwooded Chardonnay is obviously 100% stainless steel fermented. And then our other Chardonnay was actually the same fruit we split right after press, and we put it right into large oak punches and fermented that. And then went through malolactic, so it's got a nice sort of oaky butteriness to it that the stainless steel doesn't have. The stainless steel is so true to its varietal character. The next wine, which is probably, I think, our most interesting one, which is Pinot Blanc. So there are not a lot of them up here right now, and we're huge fans of it. So we planted 3 acres already. We planted 2 more last year. We're hoping to plant a little bit more next year as well. So we probably have between 5 and 7 acres in total of Pinot Blanc, and we just love it. I mean, it produces these great, large, golden clusters. Really nice fruit. Creates a really unique wine. So I think that's probably one of our favorite wines, and unfortunately we did not produce that much of it this year. So about 52 cases, I think, at the end of the day. So we just didn't have a lot of fruit. There's no place to get it around here. It's not like there's a lot sitting around. Then we have a Pinot Gris, which is sort of, it's a little bit sweeter than our first 2 wines. Our first 2 wines are effectively dry, the Pinot Blanc and the unwooded Chardonnay. This has got probably about 0.5 to 0.75% residual sugar. Nice sweetness, great deck wine. I mean, that's my favorite time. Ice cold on the deck, really tastes great. Gewürztraminer, a little bit sweeter yet than our Pinot Gris. It's considered a medium sweet wine. It has, you know, the great floral bouquet, but it's contained. It's not so overwhelming like some of those things that you see out there. You definitely won't mistake it for anything else. And then the last one we're tasting right now is the Riesling. Riesling is a semi-sweet as well. It's sitting right around 2.5 to 3% residual sugar. But it's got crisp acidity, so it doesn't taste, I don't think, as sweet as what people would think when I say how much sugar is in it. So it's kind of, you know, it's got an interesting long finish. It has all those great sort of Riesling mineral characteristics. And then obviously last is our cider, Chaos Ciders. That name comes from actually our corporation, which is Chaos Vintners. And we were trying to come up with a name for the winery. We weren't there yet, but boy, everything was chaotic. We're trying to plant all these, you know, vineyards, build a tasting room, make our own wines, do all these different things. So everything felt chaotic, and so we felt like it would be fun to do Chaos Ciders as our playful cider. And so that's where the name Chaos comes from. And that's a nice hard apple cider, local grown apples, crisp. It's great. Love the pizza. It's my favorite pizza drink right now. Verterra, which is our name, is a made-up word. It's two Latin root words that we formed into one. So ver, which is Latin for true, and terra, which is Latin for land. So the idea is being true to our land. So we wanted to be true to the essence of Leelanau County, and so almost all of our wines are 100% Leelanau County, Leelanau Peninsula wines. That's what we want to stay true to, and that's what we're trying to produce here, is good quality wines with our own fruit. There's no guarantee. I'll say love is such a